What's up, people of the internet? I'm the big boat here with yet another video. In this video we will be testing the NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1050 mobile, which is a Pascal based mid-range GPU from January 2017. Despite the 4 GB of VRAM, this is not a 1050 Ti because it has 640 shaders instead of 768. Of course I'm using the latest drivers for it as of the making of the video. I undervolted it using MSI Afterburner in order to improve thermal performance. Here's my curve. We will be testing it together with the Intel Core i7-7700HQ, which is a Kaby Lake based 4-core and 8-threaded CPU from January 2017 once again, with turbo boost clock speeds of up to 3.80 GHz. I undervolted it as well for the same reason, by 100 MV. We also have 8 GB of RAM and a 1 TB hard drive as the system drive. Yes, I don't have an SSD, ouch. As for operating system, I'm using Atlas OS 20H2. You can find a full description of the specs in the video description down below. Finally, here's a picture of the laptop, aka the PC featured in this video. The game that we will be running today is The Witcher 3 Next Gen Update in DirectX 11 mode. I will also test it in DirectX 12 mode if you want to. And yeah, let's get straight to the point.
Faster.
By the way, the reason why I'm not just exploring the countryside or whatever you wanna call it with my horse like all benchmarkers do, and instead I'm also testing the performance in Novigrad, the game's big city, well, it's because the city is actually much more demanding than the countryside, especially on the CPU side of things. And if you look at the CPU utilization, you can see that the i7 is actually being stressed out here. You could say that it's struggling even. If you have Linus tech tips like standards of playability, the RAM utilization is also higher than usual.
faster. Come on, Roach.
Let's go!
Now it is. Let's dance.
Come on, Roach.
Get in from some area.
Careful, you scab. This is no big raid.
Why are you wandering the streets, eh?
You watch where you're walking.
Degeneracy. The downfall of civilization.
Let's go.
Oh wow, that is rough. You know, as someone who not that long ago used a laptop with much weaker specs, I could play with these FPS if I had no other choice, but let's be real here. If you have similar specs to the ones that the laptop featured in this video has, you probably aren't gonna be happy playing The Witcher 3 at 18 FPS. Not to mention that I'm actually targeting a minimum of cinematic 24 FPS average. So yeah, let's skip this part of the video, and I will also skip the 900p maximum settings part, since the final result still wasn't at least 24 FPS average. Ahead to the 720p maximum settings part.
Down all of civilization.
So, that is how the Witcher 3 next gen update works on the GTX 1050 mobile and i7-7700HQ, using DirectX 11 mode. If one of you mother quackers want to see how it runs with the quote-unquote, normal DirectX 12 mode, then I will have to take your request, cause I love taking your requests, and yeah, until the next one, it's a bye-bye.